chuck me a microphone.
Hey, let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. All right. All right. Well, first of all, I just want to say thank you, you guys. We knew something was going on. didn't know this was going on. Knew something was. But, man, we've just been so blessed by you guys. The Lord has been so faithful in our life. Just all around. And I just kind of want to tell you guys a little bit of what's going on, why we feel like we need to go to Seattle, all that kind of stuff. I want to share my experience with you guys. Not as validation. I don't really care if you want us to go or not go. It's already happening. We already signed a lease, so it's done. It's done. But really just because I just want to encourage you guys that the Lord is still speaking and still wants to speak to us. You know, that when I think so often we can get this misconception that the Lord speaks to a pastor, speaks to someone that's more spiritual than us, and then we just kind of are just on the lower end of the spectrum, just like, well, I hope that they can hear from God so that I can hear from God through them or something like that. But I want to encourage you. God wants to speak to you directly, and he wants to have a one-on-one conversation with you. So I just kind of want to lead you through that conversation that the Lord had with me and Brenna. So the crazy thing about all of this is kind of the timeline that it all happened. If you have been a part of our church for a while, or if you have been here through this past summer, then you know that back in July, me and my wife were asked to take over as lead pastors of the church for a season. And I want to say it was September, right? September, I remember having a conversation with Brent, and I said, I don't know why, but I feel like we're supposed to leave the church. Which is the wrong time to say that. When we're, like, especially if you remember that season that we were in, it was like, what? What? No. And I remember I told Brent, I'm going to say this. I don't know if this is right, or if you feel this is like the same, but I'm going to say this. I feel like we might be supposed to leave the church. And she said, I feel the same way. And that was crazy. And that kind of got us started on this journey with kind of seeking the Lord of what's the next step for us to do, what we're supposed to do, all that kind of stuff. And so I remember I called one of my mentors, Landon. I said, Landon, this is what I'm feeling. I don't have a clue what to do about it. and he said, well, you just need to go on a fast and ask the Lord if you're supposed to stay here in Fort Worth or if you're supposed to move. And that was kind of it. And he said, go on a 3-day fast and seek the Lord and see what the Lord says. I think before we go any further, I want to just say that, like, if you're in a major life change, or if you are feeling some sort of, like, I feel like I need to quit my job, or I need to start this job, or I need to marry this person, or whatever, you know, whatever your big questions may be, I want to be my friend Landon to you and just say, you need to seek the Lord and see what he wants you to do. So often I think that we can do what we want to do and then just try and drag the blessings of the Lord over to where we're at. When in reality, that's a way to live a Christian life. I do think there's a better way. I would much rather not have to drag God to my plans. I'd much rather just be where he wants me to be and then just watch the blessings of God just fall on my life. I don't want to have to, like, say, God, okay, I'm going to do this, and I'm going to do everything that I want to do, and then as an afterthought say, oh, yeah, God, by the way, can you bless this over here? Like, but can we just be real? That's most of us. Like, that's most of us, most of our lives, and most of our decisions. Like, we don't ever say, hey, God, should I quit my job? Because we're already like fed up. You know, we're like done. I'm done. I'm out of here. But I do believe the Lord wants to speak to you, and he wants to give you some sort of direction for your life. And we're not just supposed to be blindly walking through this thing. You know, like if the Bible declares that the path to life, the path to following Jesus, is a narrow path, and the Bible says that few will find it. It also says that the Bible is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. So I'm just, my big questions to you is, if we want to walk the destiny that God has for us, and if we believe that that destiny is in a narrow path that few find, and that we'll need the word of the Lord to be able to find it and walk on this path, how are we going to find that path if we never, ever, ever ask the Lord for his guidance on where we're supposed to go? Like, if the Lord is saying that our path, that the path that he has for us, which he does have a path to life for you, says in Jeremiah 29:11 that he has a plan, a future for you. It's a plan to prosper you, not to harm you. So like when we talk about the plans of God, the good things that he has in store for us, it's not at all like this like torture road. But it is this road that we have to ask him, God, reveal your plan, reveal the next steps for me in my life, and then we will just watch him as he begins to speak to us, direct us, and then confirm, word after word after word. And so my friend said, go on a fast. Ask the Lord, where are we supposed to go? Are you supposed to stay? Are you supposed to go? And so the day before our fast, we started like 2 or 3 days later. The day before our fast, I couldn't sleep, and I remember I don't know, maybe you're not like me, but I'm convinced that either if I'm asleep or if I can't sleep, number one, I'm going to read the Bible, and that's going to make me sleepy. Come on. Or if it's the devil trying to keep me up, so it's either the devil trying to keep me up, and if I start reading the Bible or start worshiping, then I'll just eventually fall asleep because he's going to get frustrated. Or the other option is the Lord wants to speak to me, and if I start reading the Bible or if I start worshiping, then he'll speak to me. Those are my two options when I can't sleep. Or Facebook. let's be real. If I'm feeling spiritual, those are the two options. If I'm not, it's Facebook or Instagram. Or YouTube. God bless social media. God bless Texas. So I remember I woke up. It was around 2 or 3 in the morning. I went to my living room, and I just turned on some worship music, put on some headphones, and I just began to worship the Lord in my living room. And I mean, I can get into some worship, especially if I'm by myself. And so I'm just kind of doing my little dances, you know. Thank you, Lord. Yeah. You know. And all of a sudden, I had an and this has never happened to me in my life. I had an open vision. And if you've never experienced this, it was freaky for me. It'll probably be freaky for you. And so if I'm freaking you out right now, I'm right there with you. And so I remember I was praying in my living room, and I had my eyes closed, but it was like my eyes were open. And I was looking around my living room, and then I looked up, and then the ceiling from our living room was gone. And it was all just like the night sky up above me. And then all around the border of my house were angels peering in over the side of my living room. They were watching me worship. And I said to the Lord, I said, Jesus, this is amazing, but where are you? Because angels are cool, but I want Jesus. And so he said, look. And when I looked down, and where my coffee table is in my living room, I saw this glowing man. I saw Jesus in my living room, and I was overwhelmed. I fell on my face, and I just began to weep, but like at the same time, again, my eyes are closed this whole time, but I'm like, I'm in it, you know, I'm seeing it. This is real. It's the most real experience I've ever had in my life, and I fall on my face. I begin to weep, but it's like I'm still standing up, I guess, in the spirit realm, however you want to look at that, and I'm looking at Jesus, and I'm looking at myself on the floor, and then when I look back at Jesus, then he begins to take over my dance that I had. And while I was dancing over Jesus, Jesus began to dance over me. He flew me out to my house, flew my house. Again, I've never had an experience like this before. I can't emphasize that enough because I don't want you to think like this is normal or like I'm a freaky, super spiritual person. You know, some people can have so many visions that you're like, I don't even know if that's real anymore. I'm telling you, this is the only thing I've ever had in my life like this. And I remember I flew out from my house. I looked back at my house. If you've been to my house before, you know that it's got these white stucco columns, and then in between the columns is red brick. And all the white columns that were stucco were glowing white, like my house was a beacon for the city of Fort Worth. And I looked down towards downtown Fort Worth. I live in downtown Fort Worth, like around the border. And so I was looking towards downtown Fort Worth, and it was pitch black. And then I looked back towards my house, and it's this beacon, glowing white beacon. And then there's a beam of light that was going straight up to heaven and down to my house. And then angels were going back and forth from my house to heaven. Craziness, okay? So I'm having this crazy experience in my living room at 3 in the morning. Brenna's sound asleep, by the way. I'm much more spiritual than she is. And at the end of all this, we're back in my living room, and I just remember saying, Jesus, you're here. We're about to go on this fast. What are we supposed to do? Are we supposed to go or are we supposed to stay? And then he said, Seattle. Boom. Everything went black. Fast forward, so that was the day before our fast. We go through our fast for 3 days. I ask Brenna every day, I say, hey, have you heard from the Lord? No. Have you? Yes, I have, but I'm not going to tell you anything. And then my big thing, though, is I didn't want her to have like this I don't want her to think you planted this city into my mind, because when we go over there and it's hard and we miss our family, I don't want her to have the reason to say, you drug me to this city that I don't want to go to. I want her to hear from the Lord, because I know the Lord is faithful and he can speak to me, then he can speak to her. And so the third day of our fast, she was in her car, she was praying, and she said, Lord, are we supposed to stay in Fort Worth? And just had like this feeling of just like restlessness or like just tight, unpeace. And then she just said, are we supposed to move to Florida? Are we supposed to move this place? And she said, are we supposed to move to Seattle? And then just peace came over her. And she said, so I think we might be supposed to move to Seattle. I told her my experience, and I said, I think we're supposed to move to Seattle. That Sunday, we were in service, and then one of her friends was supposed to show up. She didn't show up until after service. We went to downtown Fort Worth afterwards to have lunch, and we're walking around showing her all these cool coffee shops and telling her about how awesome Fort Worth is. I mean, raving on Fort Worth, how good Fort Worth is. We love Fort Worth. It's amazing. And in the midst of all that, she says to us, she says, hey, have you ever considered moving anywhere besides Fort Worth? And we said, no. And she said, well, if you could move anywhere, where would you move? And I said, I don't think I'd move anywhere else. I really like Fort Worth. And she said, I said, where would you move if you had to move anywhere else? And she said, Seattle. And that started, we see Seattle almost every day, right? Somewhere. Someone's wearing a Seattle t-shirt. Someone is from Seattle. Someone's talking about, oh, it's raining, like we're in Seattle. Like, I mean, it's just everywhere. It's absolutely everywhere in our life. And God has just been like confirming. And if the Lord speaks to you, he will never speak to you a word that is not going to be confirmed. He is faithful, and he will prove himself faithful. So if he speaks one word to you, he will always confirm the word. The word is always backed up on itself. If you look in Scripture, the way that we know if a Scripture is the right context or the right word or the right way we're supposed to interpret that word is because it's backed up by more Scripture. The word of the Lord is always confirmation upon confirmation upon confirmation. And so I called my friend Lane. I said, hey, I think we're supposed to move to Seattle. He said, that's so crazy, because I've actually been talking to the pastor that I know in Seattle about you guys. And I said, he said, I don't know if they're going to pick Seattle, but if they do, you should really consider hiring them. And so he got us connected to this pastor. The pastor flew us out, paid for absolutely everything. We didn't spend a dime on that trip. And the whole thing was, he's like, I just want you to see Seattle and just see what it's all about, and just see our church and just consider maybe joining us. Keep in mind, they didn't have a position open for us. That was the weirdest thing. They're showing us all around, and then I remember after the first service, I said to Brenna, I said, I don't know what they want us to do because they have enough people and there's no spot for us. There's not a place for us. And then through some weird circumstances, a spot became available. And so they've asked me and Brenna to be over their youth and young adults ministry for now. And I mean, we don't know necessarily what all the future holds for the church, but the church has been exploding over there. And God has just been so faithful. Whenever we walked into church, I've been at this church for 9 years. I've never walked into another church and thought, I would like to join this church, or like, this is home for me. And when we walked into the door, it was like, this is our home. And I can't explain to you, I'm sure most of you guys in this room are like, I know what that feels like, because that was how I felt when I first came here, you know? And we had that same feeling. The hardest thing for us was that it was at another church. And for us, this is not an easy transition. This is not a transition that we sought out. This wasn't something that we were so mad at someone, so we just had to get out of here, you know, or anything like that. It was just that the Lord spoke to us, and that we were just like, all right, if God's gonna speak to us and he's gonna give us a word, then we just have to follow it. We have to move. I remember, like I said, the church wasn't hiring, and before they gave us an offer or anything, I told Brenna, I said, hey, if we have to move, or if we have to work at Seattle or at Starbucks in Seattle, we're moving to Seattle. Period. Like, we're not. This isn't like a maybe if they hire us or if we can get a job at a church, then we'll join and then we'll move. It was, our lease ends in April. We're finding a place and we're moving. If they hire us, that's amazing. But if they don't, then I believe that the Lord will always open up another door or the right door. And it wasn't a, like granted, we loved the church. We wanted to go there and everything, but like, I was totally cool with stepping out of being in like a formal ministry role, because I felt like that was what the Lord gave us a city, and I just knew that he could open a door for many more things after that. And so I mean, I don't encourage you guys. I mean, the Lord wants to speak to you. He wants to give you a word, you know? It's not like my story is not just a runoff story that's like God doesn't do that except for super spiritual crazy people or anything like that. No, the Lord wants to speak to you. Like, in the same way that Ryan came up on stage and used the Lord to speak through him to confirm a feeling or an emotion that you had in your chest, you know, like that. Like, that was the Lord through Ryan speaking to you. Like, when Pastor Gary will come over and he'll start like either reading your mail or like going through and like just giving you word after word after word of like speaking to you, and you're like, and like you can either be like, Pastor Gary's like really thinks I'm amazing, you know, he's like I'm gonna go preach to the nations or whatever. No, the Lord is speaking to you through someone else. But here's the thing, I said this, I've been kind of talking about this. I got asked to speak at a couple different churches since we made our announcement. And so the big thing that I've been saying is that, you know, if the only way or the only time that we hear from the Lord is in a worship setting or, you know, in a church building, then I would say that that's probably because you aren't seeking the Lord at your house. But does that mean that the Lord doesn't want to speak to you at your house? No. That just means that we have to have a desperation and a yearning for the Spirit of the Lord to speak to us, because he wants to speak to us. He is dying to speak to us. He is, like, still speaking, but I think so many times that we can just be so distracted and so just, that we can miss it. But I don't know about you, but I don't want to miss what the Lord has for me. I don't want to be doing my little family plan over here while the Lord's like got this amazing blessing over here on like some other side of the planet, or doing some other career, or doing something else. Like, I want to be where God's calling me to be at all times, every time, and I don't want to miss it. I don't want to miss what the Lord has for me. I do believe, though, that if we are doing our own thing, you know, the Lord is faithful to bless it. He is faithful. He loves us, and he's going to pour out blessings on us no matter where we go. But you can get a better blessing doing what he's called you to do. Amen? Amen. So I don't know what else to say, Dad. I mean, that's it. We're moving. We're excited. We're crazy. If you want to help us move, then we'll know if you're really friends. That's a real friend, is a person who helps you move. But yeah, we're super honored. I will say we have, like, serving at our church has been the joy of my life. I've given the past 9 years of my life to the church, in many different capacities, and this has been our home, and it's been so much fun. And I love every single one of you guys to death, like to pieces. You are my people, and I love you guys so much. And I think even when we move, like, we'll still be uprising people. All right, like like my number is not changing, and if it does, we will make a post about it or something. I don't know. We'll figure out some way to get you my number, but our numbers aren't changing. We're still in contact, and FaceTime strangely makes things so much closer. Like, we live in a time where, like, far off places cannot feel so far off. And so please, like, when we leave, don't, like, we didn't die, okay? So, like, call us, like, spend some time with us on FaceTime, like, set up an appointment to, like, hey, Alex, let's go get coffee over FaceTime. Like, I will meet you for coffee over FaceTime. I would love to. But yeah, we love you guys. We're going to miss you so much. Yeah, we love you guys.
That's awesome. Thank you, Alex. Don't leave. Brenda, do you have anything you want to share? Could I get you to come up here, though? If I could get everybody to stand. We've got some more stuff. We've got some videos, a lot of funny stuff we want to do for you guys. Just come stand by your hubby. But I just want to pray over y'all. Jeremy's coming. April, could you come up here? I just want to pray a blessing over them. You know, in the Old Testament, a father would bless his son, and but that father was about to die, and I'm not dying, so don't get your hopes up. But I just want to pray over them. I just want us to pray an uprising, Holy Ghost, anointed blessing over them. You know, the next few weeks for them is going to be a blur. It's going to be exciting. It's going to be fun. Everything's going to be new and different. Then reality is going to step in. And the Holy Ghost is going to step in. And I'm just so excited about, I just can't imagine what all God is going to do because of your obedience. And so let me just, your two hands there. I just want to, y'all can stay together. Let us pray. Lord, in Jesus' name, we thank you for Alex and Brenna. Lord, we come to you now, God, and we just thank you, God, that your hand is on them, your spirit is in them, and your power will flow through them. Lord, we just declare, God, the power of the Holy Ghost in their lives, in Jesus' name. Lord, I just thank you, God, for the open doors that are ahead of them. Lord, I thank you that the door that is open now is only open a crack, God, but there is coming a wave, Lord, that is going to carry them through a door that's bigger than they've ever imagined. Lord, I thank you, God, that there's a door that's opening that's going to put them on bigger stages than they've ever dreamed possible. That they're going to walk on stages and see thousands and thousands of people in front of them. Lord, and I thank you, God, that that's your calling for their life. I thank you, God, that like a herald, God, the sound of God will come out of them. It will declare the goodness and the greatness of God. It will propel them, God. They will ride the sound of heaven, Lord, as if it's a wave. God, I thank you, God, that that sound, God, will echo ahead of them, and it will move the powers of the enemy that would try to destroy them. I thank you, God, that the sound of heaven is coming out of them, and it will take them further than they thought they could go. God, I thank you, God, that your word is going to come out of them, Lord God, through media, God, through the spoken word, through the written word, through songs, God, your word is going to come out of them. Lord, and I declare over Alex and Brenna that the gifts have not even really been opened. Lord, the gifts in them have not even really been opened. Lord, let me say that again. God, I declare that the gifts that we have seen, the gifts that the world has experienced to this point, have not even really been opened. Lord, it's like it's a brand new toy. They've just only been reading the owner's manual. God, but you are downloading the Holy Ghost and power, the owner manual through them, God, that their life is going to excel in a rate, in a pace that it will blow our minds and it will blow their minds. I thank you, God. Lord, Seattle doesn't know what's coming. The devil doesn't know what's coming. God, but there's going to come an echo from the top north corner of the United States, God, and it's not just going to stay on this side of the border, but it's going to jump across and echo into Canada. Lord, the sound of God is going to come out of them and take them to Alaska. Lord, it's going to take them nationwide, God, and beyond the nations. I thank you, God, for your power. Lord, God, is stronger than any enemy that's ever got in their way. Lord, God, your power in them is stronger than anything that has ever tried to stop them. Lord, God, and I just speak confidence over them. Lord, I thank you, God, for a confident spirit. Spirit. God, let that roaring lion roar out of them, God. Lord, I thank you, God, that, Lord, you are like a, Lord, your word is going to come out of them like a roar, like a lion would make, God, and it is going to scare the enemy. I thank you, God. I thank you, God, for what you're doing in them, through them, God, and I thank you, God. Hallelujah for all these things in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Alex, specifically to you, I see the word of God opening up in a way you've never experienced it before. You're going to preach some of your greatest messages, and they weren't anything that were planned. Hallelujah. Lord, I thank you, Lord, that like a sword, when he opens his mouth, the word of God will come forth in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, sharamoko kitaramoko. He sharamoko kitaramaha. I hear the Lord saying, I'm pouring concrete on your feet. They can be moved by me, but they will be moved by nothing else.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. The wind may blow, the storm may rise, but God says, I will be the only one that moves you. Lord, and I thank you. Lord, I hear the word saying that this move is because of me. This move is because of my calling. This move is because of what I spoke to you. And what you saw in your living room is only the beginning of what you will see. You will begin to say, I've had another open vision. I've had another open vision. I've had another open vision, to the point that people will think you maybe are crazy. Oh, but it is the sweet God of heaven giving you a glimpse into what he has for you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And Brenna, to you, I hear the Lord saying that what people see, they see a sweet spirit in you. But God says, I see a woman of God holding a sword. There is a strength in you that appears to be sweet. There's a strength in you that appears to be soft and supple. And it is all those things. But there is also a fierceness in you that will divide the very foundations of the world, that will separate the enemy's plan, that will destroy the works of the enemy. There is a fierceness in you that the devil is afraid of. He has tried to destroy you. He has tried to wound you. He has tried to hurt you as a young lady. But God says the fierceness of the power of God is fixing to erupt through you. And people will still say, wow, she is the sweetest thing I have ever met, but don't cross the Holy Ghost that's in her. Oh, I thank you, God, for there is a fire. There is an inferno that is in her. I thank you, God. I thank you for the books that are coming out of her. I thank you, God, that as her hand grabs a hold of a pen, God, she's not going to be able to stop. I thank you, God, that you are going to set the captives free through the spoken word, God, through the declared word and through the written word that comes out of her. I thank you, God, Lord God, that the chapter hasn't even begun. We've only had the foreword of a book. We've only seen, God, the glossary. We've only seen the listing of the chapters, and we've got excited. God, but the book is about to come to pass that you've written over her, and that book complains volumes of books that will be told of the greatness that will come out of her in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name, I anoint these hands to heal the sick. I anoint these mouths to prophesy the word of God. I anoint these eyes to see what God has declared to be seen. I anoint these ears to hear what only God can speak to you. And we close your ears and mouth and your spirit to the ways of the enemy. And we open you, God, in a way that has never been opened before in you to manifest the gifts of God in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Over to you, Alex. I've got one more word. God is going to take you to a place that you don't have talent for. God is going to take you to a place that you don't have skills for. He's going to take you to a place that is going to be beyond your ability and you can do anything. But God says, I'm taking you to a place that you can't do it on your own. But I will be your power and I will be your strength and I will be your way in the dark path. I will be the thing that separates you from the normal person. God says there's plenty of talented and gifted people, but I'm calling you above it. Your gift will make a place for you, but your anointing will destroy the works of the enemy. And I declare that over you in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Lord, and for their marriage, God, I just pray, God, wholeness, completeness in Jesus' name. Let there be a bond that cannot be broken. Let there be a bond that can never be severed. In Jesus' mighty name, I thank you, God. I thank you, God, for this amazing couple. Lord, in all that they are to us and how much more they are to you. In Jesus' mighty name. Can we all say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Michelle, pizza get here?
Yes, delivered fresh.
Thank you. You guys can be seated. Y'all hang on just a minute. We know you guys love Connor Rosso. It might be a little cold, but no, you can go ahead and open it. We made them a book. The book has letters from many of you in here. It's got all kinds of pictures for the last 9 years while Alex and Brenna have been here. Y'all ain't got time to sit here and look at that. Y'all got to look at that later. Take that to your seat. Take that to your seat. Y'all have your pizza later. Before, when service is over, if you can run by real quick and sign the book, if you didn't get to put a letter in it, they would love to have you just sign some well wishes to them. Some of those pictures that are in that book, Alex, we're going to put on this screen. So you can look at that in a minute and watch the screens.
Joy to do that. So we are really excited for you guys, and we'll miss you, but we know God's hands will be with you.
you guys.
What's up, baby? Alex Perkins and the one the only hashtag, Brenna Perkins. It's Preston, and I'm here to really just say that I'm gonna miss you guys. Texas, Fort Worth is not gonna be the same without you, and your friendship over the last few years has come at a significantly divinely perfect time, and without it, I wouldn't be the same person I am today. Your friendship and your relationship over the last few years, I've been challenged, I've been inspired, and most importantly, I've been encouraged in some tough times. And Alex, you've helped me through conversations when I was wanting to dip out of commitments, and you've given me the strength and prayers to pull through, and you've also been there to pray for me when I'm at my worst, and also to celebrate me when I'm at my best, and you've really been a friend that stuck almost as close to me as a brother, and I love and respect you so much, and the adventures that we've got to share together over the last few years, I'll never forget, and I'm going to miss you in Seattle, and I pray that God will bless you, that God will expand your territory, that he would give you influence far beyond your years, and that his grace would be all over your life, and I'm just really blessed that I got to know you during this season. Because ultimately, you're going to be doing some great things for the kingdom. God's going to take you places that you never dreamed possible. And your latter days are going to be so much better than your former. And I'm grateful to be your friend. The best is yet to come. I love you.
Alex, I'm so excited for you and brother to move to Seattle, Washington. I know that God's going to do great things through you and for you because you're being obedient. It takes a lot of faith to move your entire life, but you have always had strong faith. And I want to thank you for being a good friend to me and to my family. We're going to miss you, and I'm sure the other friends are going to miss you, and the DFW Metroplex is going to miss you. But I know that the next season of your life will be incredible because you and Brenna are both so smart and so talented. We love you guys, and we're going to be praying for you.
Get your billfold out. We're going to bless them. Really? Not one sound out of the room. That's better. Come on. This is a generous church. It's our privilege to give, right? We're going to take up one more offering before we get out of here. So if I could get you to stand so you can get to your billfold better. We're going to miss them so much. This is your opportunity to sow a seed into Seattle, Washington. It is your opportunity to sow a seed into the ministry of Alex and Brenna Perkins. If you believe in them, here's what you do. You take some money out of your billfold, you take your card, you go over there and swap it with Jeremy, you write a check, and you sow into their ministry. Man, it would be worth it for you to skip lunch today to sow into them, because I promise you, it's going to come back to you. And what a blessing it is to them that we want to finance their moving. We want to finance their expenses to get there. And the way we do it is we just all dig in, right? So I got like $12 in my billfold, but I got a credit card I'm going to swap in a minute. But let's pray. And I just want you to pray. Don't hold up. Look back up at me. You fix them. Tell me. Push pay. PushPay, the timestamp will take care of it. Yeah, you can do it. You can give on PushPay. Just any tab, the timestamp will show us what that offering is for. So you can do PushPay, check, money order, cash, blood, whatever. But I want you to pray. I want you to say, God, what should I sow? If you don't pray, you're not going to do this. But I want you to pray and say, God, what should I sow into the ministry of the uprising that is going with Alex and Brenna to Seattle? And if you'll ask him, he will give you an amount. And if you'll be faithful to that, you will see God bless you. His word is true. Do you believe his word is true? Amen. The Bible says, give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over shall men give unto you. Well, this is our chance to do the end of that and expect that God is going to do it for us. Let's pray. Lord, I thank you, God, for the opportunity that we have to sow into Alex and Brenna's lives. Lord, I thank you, God, for the gift that they've been to us. Lord, and I thank you, God, that we want to put something in their hand. Lord, we just want to bless them today. Lord, and I pray that you give us a figure in our mind. Lord, show me, God, what my figure is. Show me, God, how much I should give. Lord, and I will be faithful to do that. In Jesus' mighty name, I thank you, God. I thank you for the calling, for the ministry that's going to come into their lives through the blessings that we are providing for them today. In Jesus' mighty name. Everybody said, amen, amen. Amen. Ryan's going to come and dismiss you in just a minute. Come and give. You got about 20 seconds to shake somebody's hand real quick, whatever you want to do there. And we're going to get out of here pretty quick, but don't leave yet.
All right, well, we're about to get out of here. I honestly totally forgot that I was doing dismissal today, so I probably should have prepared a little bit of something to say goodbye to Alex and Brenna. But I will tell them in a second, bye, whenever everybody else is done. All right, everybody else, y'all have y'all's moment later. I get the stage right now, and I get to say bye to them. All right, let's go. All right, well, I'm going to pray really quick, and then I'll say my bye to them. Hopefully I won't cry. It isn't just the spirit that moves me. I am a little bit of a baby. So let me pray really quick. Lord, I thank you for Alex and Brenna. Lord, I thank you for allowing them to... I see your boot scooting, Boogie. Throw me way off. And these flags are throwing me off, too. I like to walk all the way to the edge and I like to get in people's faces. All right, let me start this over. Thank you, Lord, for Alex and Brenna. Lord, I thank you for allowing them to be in our lives, Lord. And, Lord, for... Oh, my gosh, I don't want to cry. but, Lord, for thank you for blessing us with with their presence, Lord. That they have so much God on them and in them, Lord, that... It flows out to other people, Lord, and that they're such great leaders to us. And, Lord, we can just look back and see all the movements that you've used them for. Lord, I thank you for everybody here today. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for loving us, for pouring out your joy and your peace to us today, Lord. And for, again, for just letting us have people in our lives, Lord, that love us and that care for us. And Lord, I thank you that that you blessed me with such a great brother that he got to pour into my life, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. I just want to say a quick bye to them. A lot of, like, why I get worked up is because, like, I can just... I guess you could call me a feeler. Like, I feel God, like, and I have no other reaction but to cry. If I pray over you and I start crying, it's not because I'm sad or anything. It's just, I feel something, and I don't know how to explain it. But part of the reason why I'm able to get up here and speak to y'all and talk to y'all is because of Alex. It's because of my parents, because I had such great people in my life that challenged me and encouraged me to do this. I hate talking to people. I hate getting out of my comfort zone. I'm just going to be real with you for a second. I'm really bad at conversations. Like, it's hard for me to keep a conversation going with you, especially if I don't know you very well. It's hard for me to get out of my shell. Alex is laughing because he knows this is really true. And I'm not supposed to be saying this kind of stuff up here. It does make me sound really terrible. It's just, I'm shy. I'm shy, and it's hard for me to get out of my shell. And I don't care if you think I'm terrible, because I don't care what you think about me. But,
Ryan!
I mean, if I'm getting up here, you're going to get all of me, and this is how it is. But for real, the reason why I'm able to get up here and speak is because Alex asked me to. And I respect Alex a lot. And I respect just how encouraging he is and how challenging he is to us. And he asks us, or at least he asks me, to do things that I'm uncomfortable with. Because he knows, he sees something inside of me that I might not see in myself. And I appreciate that about you. And I thank you for pushing me and for just leading by example of, like what Dad was saying, of getting on stage whenever you're really young and never getting off. And a lot of people try to compare me to you growing up and asking me or telling me that not to compare myself to you. But I wrote this a little bit in my letter to y'all, but I didn't compare myself to you. I looked up to you. And I appreciate everything that you've done for me and for encouraging me and for just loving me. Whenever I was going through hard times and whenever I didn't believe in God or anything, you believed in me. And you never left my side. I thank you for that. I hope somebody else is crying with me because it'll make me feel so bad. But I really do appreciate you. And I appreciate you bearing out a lot too. And I don't want to sound like other people that have told me not to compare myself to Alex. But don't compare yourself to Alex. He is a tough person to sit next to. I understand that. But you are great. You really are. You have so much love to give to us, to me. You're just as encouraging, if not more, than Alex. And like I said, don't let anybody doubt you for a second. Don't let anybody try to compare you to Alex. And there might be a time whenever you might be in his shadow. I lived in it for a while, but enjoy the shade. Because that's a comforting place too, is not having a lot of people look at you. But a lot of people do look at you. And it is hard being a pastor's wife. And it is hard living the life that God has given you. And don't back down from it. Because you are strong. God chose you to live that life. You are strong. You are brave. Amen. You are courageous. And like that, my dad was saying, is that you might be shy and whatever and quiet, but you fight with a sword. And you fight with the Holy Spirit. And not a lot of other people do that the way that you can do that. And you won't be shy forever. You won't be afraid to get on stage forever.
I promise you, I guarantee you that.
I don't remember what I was saying, but you will, okay, I remember now. You will get on stage and you will preach stuff that nobody's heard before, and you're going to come from a different perspective than anybody else could ever think of.
Amen.
You really will. And I'll just pray really quick before I drown us all in tears. And we can get out of here and go eat. Lord, I thank you for Alex and Brennan. Lord, I thank you for the love that they've given us, for the leadership that they've provided, for the encouragement that they've given us. Lord, I thank you for giving me such great family, Lord, in my life. given me such a great brother and a great sister, Lord, that I can always lean on, Lord, and that we can all lean on, even though they might be far away in mileage, Lord, but Lord, that we are close. Lord, and I thank you, Lord, that you've just shown up today, at least for me, Lord, that you've shown up for me today, and you've given me something new today. Lord, and I thank you, Lord, that other people are experiencing the same thing today. Lord, that you have given us joy today. Lord, that you have given us peace today. Lord, that you are comforting us. Lord, that you are giving us something new today, Lord, that you're taking us to a new place. Lord, that Brenda and Alex are not the only two that are stepping into new grounds today. Lord, but our church is stepping into new places today. That new people are stepping up. That new people are getting a new drive inside of them. A new calling in their life today. An awakening in their old callings, Lord, that they thought were dead. Lord, I thank you for loving us. And I thank you for just the family that we have here today. Lord, in Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen.
You are all dismissed. Sorry, I ended on a little bit of a crying note.